Students, you will be giving most important exam of your school life from 21st April 2021 onwards. Due to corona pandemic, this academic year was challenging for you all in terms of offline teaching and learning process. In spite of that, I am sure all of you studied well with full passion and confidence throughout the year. So, we really appreciate everyone's hard work. But if any student still not assured and confident about their studies, then no worries. Here, Asim Gyan Channel have started a series for providing helping hand to all students. In this series, we are going to solve all your queries related to Science 1 and Science 2 to make you feel confident about your studies. The name of the series is SSC at One Glance, a complete guidance series. Concept, direction and coordination by Mr. B.B. Jadhav sir. Students of SSC must watch for complete revision and understanding. Myself, Priyanka Parkar from VPMS Vidyamandir, Dahisar East. I will be taking one important lesson of Science 1, that is lesson number 7. Lenses. Before we start with the topics, I will like to introduce paper pattern of Science 1 and Science 2. So there are in all 4 questions. Question 1 include A and B part of 5 marks each. Question 1A contains MCQs based on textbook. Question 1B contains 1 mark objective questions which may include odd one out, complete the correlation, true or false type of questions. This B section does not have fill in the blanks. You can use 20 minutes to solve this whole question. Question 2A give reasons, any 2 out of 3. Each question carry 2 marks. Question 2B write answer in short. Any 3 out of 5, each question carry 2 marks. Here, questions like define the following, numericals, laws, diagram based questions, difference between, draw diagrams, applications, such type of questions can be asked. You can utilize 30 minutes for this question. Question 3 is answer the following. Any 5 out of 8. Each question carry 3 marks. Here, questions can be included as paragraph based questions, complete the flowchart or complete the table, explain with the help of diagram, numericals, laws, etc. You can utilize 40 minutes to solve this complete question. Question 4 is 5 mark question, where you have to solve any 1 out of 2. It's a long answer type question where you should write answer in detail along with a diagram if necessary. Or maybe diagram based 5 questions will be asked of 1 marks each. You can utilize 10 minutes for solving this 5 mark question. Likewise, if you solve your paper with this time management, then last 10 minutes you can utilize for rechecking of your answer paper and for underlining important words of your answer. Now, let's start our journey to understand the concept of lenses. I'm sure all of you are very much familiar with this word lenses. You must have seen lenses used in day-to-day life. But what does it exactly means? So, lens is a transparent medium bound by two surfaces. Lens is of two types, convex lens and concave lens. Convex lens, the lens which has two spherical surfaces which are puffed up outwards, is called convex lens. This lens is thicker near the center as compared to the edges. Convex lens is also called as converging lens. Concave lens, the lens which has two spherical surfaces curved inwards, is called concave lens. This lens is thinner near the center. Concave lens is also called as diverging lens. Both concave and convex lenses further are of these three types: biplano and positive or negative meniscus. Both these lenses are useful in our daily life. Let's learn uses of concave lenses. It is used in medical equipment, scanner, CD player. These instruments use laser light. For proper working of these equipments, concave lenses are used. The peephole indoor. It's a safety device which helps us to see outside the door, which uses one or more concave lenses. Concave lens is used in spectacles to correct myopia. Concave lens is used to spread widely the light produced by a small bulb inside a torch. To get good quality images, a concave lens is used in front of the eyepiece or inside it. Usually, camera, telescope and microscope uses convex lens. But to get good images, concave lenses are also fit in front of the eyepiece or inside it. Now, let's learn uses of convex lens. It is used in simple microscope. A convex lens with small focal length produces a virtual erect and 20 times bigger image in simple microscope. Simple microscope is used for watch repair, testing precious gems, etc. Compound microscope. They are used to study minute objects like cells, bacteria, etc. Convex lens is used in both types of telescope, that is refracting and reflecting telescope. Convex lenses are used in various optical instruments like camera, projector, spectrograph, etc. Convex lenses are used in spectacles for correcting hypermetropia. Okay, now it's time to understand some important terms related to lens. We will take help of this figure. The surface S1 is a part of sphere S1, whereas surface S2 is a part of sphere S2. First term is center of curvature. The centers of spheres of which the lens is a part is called as center of curvature of the lenses. Radius of curvature. The radii of spheres whose parts form surfaces of the lenses are called radii of curvature of the lens. R1 and R2 are radii. Third is principal axis. The imaginary line passing through both center of curvature is called as principal axis. for this optical center O. The point inside a lens on the principal axis through which light rays pass without changing their path is called as optical center of a lens, that is O. Next term is principal focus of convex lens. When light rays parallel to principal axis are incident on a convex lens, they converge to a point on a principal axis. This point is called as principal focus of convex lens. Since in convex lens, rays are coming together, that is, they converge here. Hence, convex lens is also called as converging lens. Principal focus of concave lens. When light rays parallel to principal axis are incident on a concave lens, they diverge after refraction in a such a way that they appear to be coming out of a point on the principal axis. This point is called as principal focus of concave lens. In concave lens, rays are diverging, that is, they are going away from each other. Hence, concave lens is also called as diverging lens. Next term is focal length. The distance between the optical center and the principal focus of a lens is called as focal point, is called as focal length. Focal length of convex lens is positive, whereas focal length of concave lens is negative. Now, let's learn rules to draw ray diagrams of concave and convex lens. There are three rules. First rule is, when incident rays parallel to principal axis, refracted ray pass through principal focus. Rule 2. When incident ray pass through principal focus, refracted ray parallel to principal axis. Rule 3. When incident ray pass through optical center, refracted ray will pass without changing its direction. So these are the three rules which are useful for drawing ray diagrams of images formed by convex or concave lens. Now, this table indicates nature, size, and position of the image formed by convex lens for different positions of the object. Say, for example, object at infinity, object at 2f1, and so on. Based on this, complete the table kind of questions will come for 2 or 3 marks, where position of the object will be given. Say, for example, position of the object is at f1, and this will be kept as blank. So you have to write down the image of the position of the image, that is at infinity, size of the image, that is highly enlarged, nature of the image, that is real and inverted. So likewise, this type of question may come in your exam, or maybe any one diagram will be given and based on which the table will be asked. So this table is really very important as far as your exam. This is a table for images formed by convex lenses for different positions of the object, and these are their ray diagrams. Next topic is sign convention. According to Cartesian sign convention, optical center O is taken as origin. All the distances measured to the right of O are considered as positive, and left of the lens are considered as negative. Distance measured above principal axis are positive, and below it are negative. As we saw previously, principal focus of convex lens is on right side. That's why focal length of convex lens is positive, whereas principal focus of concave lens is on left side. That's why the focal length of concave lens is negative. Now, this is lens formula 1 upon b minus 1 upon u is equal to 1 upon f, where b is the image distance, u is the object distance, and f is the focal length. Magnification formula is m is equal to height of image upon height of object, that is h2 upon h1, which is also equal to b upon u. Next concept is power of lens. The power of lens is the reciprocal of its focal length. It is defined as the capacity of lens to converge or diverge incident rays is called as its power of lens, that is P. Formula is P is equal to 1 upon F in meter, where F is the focal length and P is the power of lens. SI unit of power is diopter, which is represented as capital D. One diopter is the power of lens whose focal length is 1 meter. Students, please always remember that the power of convex lens is positive, whereas power of concave lens is negative. This is really very important again for your exam. Now, let's solve one sum based on this concept. Doctor has prescribed a lens using power plus 1.5 diopter. What will be the focal length of the lens? What is the type of the lens used, and what must be the defect of vision? So given here is power of lens is given, that is P is equal to plus 1.5D. So, and they ask us to find out the focal length. So focal length small f is equal to question mark. Formula is P is equal to 1 upon f. Let's use the formula to solve this one. So this is the solution. We want to find out f. So therefore it will be f is equal to 1 upon p, that is 1 upon 1.5, and the answer will be f is equal to plus 0.66 meter. This is the focal length of the lens. Now further they ask, what is the type of lens used? Now how will you answer this question? So this will be based on positive or negative power which is used. Since here it is positive power, so since the power of lens is positive, type of lens is convex lens, and hence the defect of vision is hypermetropia. Okay, now this kind of sum may come in your exam. Now it's time to learn most important part of our body, that is structure of eye. First part is cornea, which is thin transparent membrane on the human eye. Light enters the eye through it. Now next part is iris. It's dark fleshy screen present behind the cornea. It's a colorful part of our eye. The color of the iris is different for different people. Next is pupil. Small hole of changing diameter at the center of the iris is pupil. It controls amount of light entering the eye. There is double convex lens present just behind the pupil. It creates real and inverted image of an object on the screen inside the eye. Now, this screen is made up of light sensitive cells and it is called as retina. These cells are shaped like rod and like a comb. Rod-like cells respond to the intensity of light. It gives information about the brightness and dimness of the object, whereas conical cells respond to the color and give information about the color of the object to the brain. These cells get excited when light falls on them and generate electrical signal. These signals are conveyed to the brain through optic nerves. So this is the structure and some important parts of our eye. Now let's learn meaning of power of accommodation. The capacity of the lens to change its focal length as per need is called as its power of accommodation. When the image is far away, then the eye lens becomes thin and its focal length increases. Whereas when it is nearby, then the eye lens becomes thick and focal length decreases. Now, the next concept is minimum distance of distinct vision. The minimum distance of an object from a normal eye at which it is clearly visible without a stress on the eye is called as minimum distance of distinct vision. The position of object at this distance is called as near point of the eye. For a normal human eye, the near point is 25 cm. Now let's learn defects of vision. First defect is myopia, or it is also called as nearsightedness. The eye can see nearby objects clearly, but the distant objects appear indistinct. That is, cannot able to see distant object clearly. In myopia, the image of distant object forms in front of the retina like this. The reasons are the curvature of the cornea and the eye lens increases. The muscles near the lens cannot relax so that the converging power of the lens remains large. The second reason is the eyeball elongates so that the distance between the lens and the retina increases. This defect can be corrected by using spectacles with concave lens. Now, the next defect is hypermetropia, that is farsightedness. The eye can see distant objects clearly, but cannot see nearby objects distinctly, that is hypermetropia, that is farsightedness. In hypermetropia, the image of nearby objects forms behind the retina like this. The reasons are the curvature of the cornea and the eye lens decreases. The converging power of the lens becomes less. Second reason is due to the flattening of eyeball. The distance between the lens and the retina decreases. This defect can be corrected by using spectacles with convex lens. Next is presbyopia, which is also called as old age hypermetropia. The focusing power of the eye lens decreases with the age. The muscles near the lens lose their capacity to change the focal length of the lens. The near point of the lens shifts farther from the eye. Because of this, old people cannot see nearby objects clearly. This is called as presbyopia or old age hypermetropia. Next concept is bifocal lens. Sometimes people suffer from nearsightedness as well as farsightedness. In such case, bifocal lens are required to correct the defect. In such cases, the upper part is concave lens and corrects nearsightedness, whereas the lower part is a convex lens which corrects farsightedness. So here I covered the important topics of this lesson. I hope you all understand all the concept very well. Let me take a small quiz to check your understanding. So the first question is, convex lens is also known as dash. Can you guess the answer? So the correct answer is converging lens. If your answer is correct, then give yourself a high five. Very good. Now let's see second question. When the object is placed between f1 and 2f1 of convex lens, where will be the position of image? Can you guess the answer? This is little bit tougher. So the correct answer is D, beyond 2f2. Third question. Dash is a colorful part of our eye. Come on, now this is an easy one. Here the correct answer is iris. That is a colorful part of our eye. Fourth question. Identify the defect of vision given in the diagram. So here we can see the image form in front of the retina. So this defect is nothing but myopia. I hope all of you has guessed the answers correctly. Now as far I covered paper pattern, important topics of this lesson and a short quiz. Now we came to the end of this session, in which we will focus on the questions asked in last year's board question papers. So in 2018, the question asked, draw a neat label diagram of structure of the human eye for 2 marks. So this is how you can draw a structure of a human eye, and these are the important parts of human eye which are necessary to be shown in your diagram. Second question asked in the same year is, Kavita from 10th is using spectacle. The power of the lenses in her spectacle is -2.5 diopter. Answer the following question. This question is asked for 3 marks. Which lenses are used in her spectacles? State the defect of vision Kavita is suffering from. Find the focal length of the lenses used in her spectacles. So, the first answer, which lenses are used in her spectacles? That answer we can solve by given information that the power of lens here it is negative. So, the spectacle uses concave lens. State the defect of vision. So, since it is a concave lens used, so defect of vision will be myopia or nearsightedness. To find a focal length, we will use the formula f is equal to 1 upon p. Here it will come 1 upon p, that is 1 upon 2.5, and the correct answer is 0.4 meter. Now in 2019, the question asks, observe the following figure and complete the table. Here this diagram of convex lens is given, ray diagram of convex lens is given. This question asked for 2 marks and table was given where these points were given and we need to answer. So with the help of diagram we can see the position of the object is between F1 and O. Position of the image is between F1 and 2F1, that is on the same side as that of the object. We can observe the size of the image is larger than the object, so it is very large, and since it is on the same side of the object, so this image is virtual and it is erect. So virtual and erect. Second question asked in the same year is of 3 marks. Surbhi from 10th is using spectacle. The power of the lens in her spectacle is 0.5 diopter. Answer the following questions. Identify the type of lenses used in her spectacles. Identify the defect of vision. Find the focal length. So here again, the power of lens, here it is given positive. Since the power of lens is positive, the lens uses convex lens. Okay, so remember, when the power of lens is positive, we use convex lens. When the power of lens is negative, then the concave lens. So here it is positive, hence convex lens. Since convex lens is used, so defect is hypermetropia or farsightedness. The focal length will be calculated by the formula F is equal to 1 upon P, that is 1 upon 0.5, that is equal to 2 meter. Okay, now in 2020, first question asked is, for the normal human eye, what is the near point? The near point is at dash centimeter. This is asked for 1 mark. The correct answer is 25, option C. You will write down your answer like this, option C. For all MCQs, you will write down answer like this only. Now the next question asks is, draw scientifically correct label diagram of human eye and answer the questions based on it. This question was asked for 5 marks. Name the type of lens in human eye. Name the screen at which the maximum amount of incident light is refracted. State the nature of the image form of the object on the screen inside the eye. So here, for a neat, clean label diagram of human eye, there is a 2 marks with all the important parts should be shown in the diagram. And this each question carry 1 mark. So this 3 question is of 3 mark. So answer of first question is, name the type of lens in the human eye. So we know it is double convex lens. Name the screen at which maximum amount of incident light is refracted. The answer is outer surface of the cornea. Nature of the image form. So in a lens, real and inverted type of image will be formed inside our eye. Okay. So these were the questions asked in the year 2020. With this, we have come to the end of this video. If this video is useful to you, then do like, share and subscribe to this channel so that you will be able to get all episodes of this series, which will be very useful for you all. Also, if you have any doubts or queries about any topic, feel free to leave comment in our comment box and we are sure to solve your doubts. Thank you all of you for watching this video. Be confident, be meritorious, achieve glory. All the best.